that we're creators. We don't see it. We don't recognize the fact that we already do. Every single moment is a thought. You're choosing a thought right now. If you become aware of the fact that you're choosing a vibration right now, you can start to more easily shift that, make that conscious. So it's not about, for the first time in your life ever, choosing a thought. You're choosing a thought right now. You're choosing a thought right now. You're choosing a thought right now. You're choosing a wavelength right now. You're choosing a frequency right now. If you were not choosing a frequency, you would not have an experience. Since you're having an experience, I'm assuming that every billionth of a second, you're choosing a vibration with or without your conscious influence. Now, you can have conscious influence on this because ultimately all that there is consciousness. So what we call the unconsciousness that generates our realities for us is actually our consciousness. But we're segregated, we're separated into layers. So there is this superficial consciousness or the person consciousness, and then there's the greater consciousness, but really there's only one consciousness. But it's the greater consciousness that generates the person consciousness that then generates all these thoughts that it doesn't realize it's generating, but it's all coming from consciousness. So the more you're tapped into consciousness itself, the more realized you are in consciousness itself, the more you realize you are consciousness and you can choose your frequency, you can choose your thought, the more obvious it will become that you've always already been creating a reality. And then all this regret and all this suffering from the past will disappear too, because you realize you created it. So it's very hard to blame someone else for your suffering if you realize you created it, huh? You've always been choosing something. Become aware of what you're choosing now, and then choose whether or not you like that choice. If you don't feel good about the choice, choose a thought that anchors you into a vibration that feels better, and it's as simple as that, and everything else will fall into place. Now, a little side note to that, just something to notice, something to observe, is that it's so much easier to choose your thought, to choose your vibration, when you recognize it's actually... it is just that. You're just consciousness choosing a thought. As soon as you include an external physical reality in your view, in your mind view, in your consciousness, then suddenly it becomes much harder to trust the fact that you can simply choose the thought that you like, that you enjoy, and then that things will flow from that. If you believe there is this reality over here, which we call your physical reality, with your circumstances and your husband and your wife and your kids and your job and your money, if you believe that actually exists, independent from you creating it in this moment, then it becomes very hard to trust the fact that you can choose a different thought. So, in a sense, it's very helpful to be in a space where you don't include an external world in your consciousness. And we've all experienced this. Whenever you're daydreaming, you're not aware of an external world. You're not referencing something outside of yourself. Whenever you're listening to me and you become absorbed in what I say, you're not referencing an external world. Whenever you just for a moment forget who you are, you're not referencing an external world. Whenever you're not referencing an external world, you're not referencing or experiencing an external world. Start to become aware of this. When you're not referencing an external world, you're not experiencing an external world, and you can't even say whether or not it exists. The answer is it doesn't. What you create within your own bubble, consciousness is like a sphere. Every I am consciousness, every one of you is like your own sphere of consciousness with this 360 movie screen, and you're constantly projecting onto the inside of that bubble. That may look like a street that goes all the way to Tokyo, and you know, that's out there, so real, everyone can walk it, other beings are walking on it. They're coming from Tokyo all the way to over here, so there must be some truth to Tokyo. Yes. But onto your own screen only, out of your own energy generated only. There is no Tokyo apart from your own energy field generated onto the screen of your three-dimensional, fourth-dimensional, fifth-dimensional, depending on your state of being, state of consciousness. So all you ever experience is what you project inside of your consciousness. When you refer to an external world, what happens is that you use your inner world, which is all that ever existed. You're using the conscious field of consciousness to generate the illusion, the sensation, which is inside, of an outside world. But you've never actually, if you're honest with yourself, experienced the outside world. You've only experienced your inner sensations of you referencing something that does not exist outside yourself. Does that make sense? But when you're in that illusion and you're referencing the external world and you make it feel real in that state, you have to think another type of thought to loosen that up. such as, oh, everything is inside of consciousness. Could be one example to counter that, to feel freed up from an external world. And when you no longer see, perceive, or reference an external world, then suddenly it's so much easier to know that you are God and that you can pick your thought, and that's all that you have to do. That's your only job, is to pick something, to pick a frequency that actually feels in alignment with who you are, that actually feels elevating, exciting, and good. When you're in that state of recognizing that all is subjective reality, there is no objective reality. When you realize this is a dream inside of consciousness, suddenly everything becomes so much easier. And so thought is simply the wavelength you're emitting, and that then projects a certain type of configuration of pictures onto this 360 view of this inside of the sphere of your consciousness. Does that make sense? Again, a very good analogy for this is to remember your dream state at night. You meet many people. You can go to Tokyo. You can hear about Tokyo while being in New York City. Does that mean that Tokyo is actually there independent from your dream experience? When you wake up, is that dream Tokyo still there somewhere, waiting for you to return to dream Tokyo? You dreamed it into existence, and now you stopped dreaming it into existence. Doesn't mean that the potential for that reality doesn't coexist with all other potential realities, but it means that it's no longer real for your experience because it doesn't actually exist independent from consciousness. Your dream does not exist independent from consciousness. Does that make sense? What makes you think it's any different here? Give no proof for an external world. You just assume there are external worlds, and you keep referencing this something outside of yourself. You have no more proof than in your dream state. Whatsoever. No more proof that there is a world out there than in your dream state whatsoever. So why do you assume that it's any different? So when you realize that it's not any different, and this is a waking dream, suddenly you can start playing with projecting things onto your screen at will. You can choose your vibration, you can pick your thought, you can pick your state of being, you can demand what things become. Of course, always with the eye of what can I learn from this experience and what is relevant for me. You know, when the egotistical mind takes over and thinks it knows what it wants for itself, but it's not really tuned into its true relevance, its true frequency, then it can get a little ahead of itself and try to create things that are actually not relevant for itself. But then you'll feel that because it will feel bad. It will feel overbearing. It will feel premature. It will simply not work out because it's not relevant for you. But that still does not mean that you cannot generate and accelerate the theme of your life being expressed more quickly and more epically, more awesomely. Simply tap into who you truly are, what is relevant for you, what excites you, and from that excitement, just live. See only your excitement. Paste it onto your reality. And things will change accordingly to the vibration of thought in that sense.